The 2023 CSU automated weeder demos are intended to address the issues that Colorado vegetable farmers face regarding the recruitment, retention, and affordability of their workforce on vegetable farms. Even when they have the option for H-2A workers, the cost is increasing for them. So these are solutions that they can explore and see what's the best fit for their farm based on the size of the machine, the cost of the machine, and how it works.
It would come to no surprise to you likely that produce growers are dealing with ongoing recruitment, retention, and affordability issues in labor. Colorado State University conducted a statewide labor survey in 2021. And one of the questions we asked, if conditions don't improve for you with labor, recruitment, retention, and affordability, what are you going to do? Looking at that chart, what's the number one response from produce growers? It says they're going to mechanize more, right? We also know from more recent CSU research that produce farms, their payroll ranges from 30 to just north of 50% of their operating cost. Real significant chunk. So what you're going to hear today and get into conversations about, and a lot of you growers are already thinking about this, is what is the return on investment for some of this machinery?
So Carbon Robotics started in 2018. We have our demo buds behind me. Our first commercial product, which is a 20-foot implement, came out last year. And we are a tech company that uses artificial intelligence and deep learning to identify the difference between weed and crops in the field and uses lasers to shoot those weeds. Well, farmers across the country, across the world, have always had uncontrollable weed issues. So what we're trying to do is to eliminate the hand-weeding crews that are a huge expense to growers and come in with the technology of AI and lasers to eliminate that hand-weeding.
Between our predict cameras and our target cameras, and on this implement we have 8 target cameras, they're identifying the weed based off of color, size, shape. It identifies them into 4 classes. So you have broadleaf, grass, offshoot, and purslane. And from there, it tells the AI or the deep learning network how long to shoot each weed for in order for the thermal energy to appropriately kill that weed.
It's continually learning. So even as we're in this field right now, it's developing a new model and makes itself better. So on, say in this instance, if it misidentified a weed and didn't shoot it, the next go around, we train it to learn what that weed is and shoot it. So it's for guys that have very high weeding bills across the country, and we're coming in eliminating 80% of those costs and have an ROI in less than 3 years.
I'm excited to see this new technology because I've seen it in the course of my career with CSU and even growing up as in a farming area in this valley. I've seen the evolution of farming and agriculture, and the main factor that's really started it on, I would say, a downward trajectory is this the availability of labor. And I think that will continue to be the most critical resource for the viability and the long-term sustainability of Colorado specialty crop production is using and finding labor correctly. And we've already seen that with some political changes, some Senate bills that changes the minimum wage and the overtime hours. And I think those things are inevitable, that evolution. But how do farmers in Colorado adapt to that? And I think really that's why this new technology is so critical. You know, we don't know if it's going to be directly applicable, but we know with any new technologies, over time they will evolve to meet the specific needs. And they'll become down in price and the technology will become more specific to what they need. And so why this is a great first step. And I'm glad that the Fruit and Vegetable Growers Association and Colorado State University and the Experiment Station have really partnered together to bring this kind of a demonstration to the farmers of the state.
So the Smart Cultivator is an AI-based cultivator. It's an auto weeder in a sense. It uses our proprietary vision to both identify plants and weeds and cultivate everything in between the plant. So it saves the plant and eliminates the weeds by mechanical actuation. So it connects to the tractor via a 3-point hitch and PTO pump. Once the PTO pump is spinning at 1,000 RPM, that pushes the hydraulics through, self-contained hydraulics, and that spins the alternator, which powers the battery, which keeps all the electronics and the cameras and the lights charged and running.
So nice.
So it uses knives, hose, through actuation. So again, the camera identifies the plants, and that sends the signal over to the mechanical actuators that will open and close around the plant, So basically anything within, anything in between the plants, it eliminates. And you can actually set your tolerances so you can be ultra aggressive and get really close up to the plant, or you can, you know, be a little extra cautious and give yourself a little more space. So the opening prior to the plant and the closing after the plant can be set entirely by you, the operator.
Well, we know that hoeing vegetables, it can be a very large ergonomic challenge for workers. So these will remove weeds across the entire bed surface, both between rows and within rows, which has historically been the big challenge for vegetable weeding. So we anticipate that this will make ergonomics so much better for workers and allow them to move into jobs on farms that are less rigorous physically.
The part that is, it's just a little hard to, for some of the growers to kind of conceptualize that this is a unit built for rugged use, rugged terrain. Traditionally, you know, machines that are in the field are beat up and destroyed. And so this kind of equipment with computers and cables and lights, the thought is that it's not built to last and it's not going to last. Stout has over 50 machines sold already throughout the country and outside of the country. And the earliest machines have 6,500 hours on them and are still running.
Farmers, I think, inherently want to try new stuff. And I, what's always fascinated my career, how inventive farmers are. They're really true inventors. I've seen some, I don't want to call it contraptions, but some really innovative ways that they've adapted pieces of machinery to suit their specific needs. So I think it's natural to them. They're also, you know, inherently by being farmers, they're risk takers. So they want to go out there. They know, you know, every day is a risk with them, with weather or something else.
So my company is Barnell Precision Agriculture. We got started originally in 2018 as a drone service provider for local farmers in the La Junta, Colorado area. After gaining really great traction providing mapping analysis and using our technology to pinpoint areas of opportunity like irrigation, insect and disease management, other concerns that farmers might have, we were talking with them and they said we really need help kind of managing labor a little bit better. And so if you can build us a small robot that can supplement our labor needs, then we would give you every acre that we have. And so we got started doing that in 2021, so we're still pretty young in our development. But since then, when we have been able to build small farm robots that do multiple different tasks from planting to weed control, they can tow 400 pounds each, so they can spray, and using that application and combination of the drone technology with the ground-based robots, we think we have a really great holistic approach as to the robots and the other farm operations that are, you know, very, very important to helping our small growers continue to grow our food for us.
I mean, I believe automation is the future with ag. Certainly our product in eliminating weeds, but harvesting, packing, there'll be all sorts of uses for this technology moving forward.
Well, the hope and the goal, at least for Stout, is to be able to provide data and analytics, live field analytics data, non-biased data that is not from a person, a single individual with thoughts and opinions of how things should work. It's going to provide real-time data on your consistency in plant spacing and your consistency in plant growth and the expected harvest. Right now it's a machine that solves, again, the weed issue, the labor issue, but we're hoping that it also solves a bigger picture, and that's with being able to have live data coming from the machine itself and feeding that to the grower for useful information, basically live inventory in your field.
Well, we're a long ways off from being ready for this type of technology, so scalability to a smaller scale is probably the foremost thing that we would look at. Cost is obviously an issue, but at some point the increase in cost of manual labor and the decrease in cost of this technology are going to cross, and they're going to make more sense for us.
Factors that are going to be important for me, price is always going to be one. But adaptability to multiple crops, and I've seen some of that today. I don't need highly specialized, I mean, I'm a very diverse, because I'm small, I play in a lot of markets, going to grocery stores, and versus some of the big players nationally that maybe specialize in one or two, I'm gonna grow 10 to 15 different crops. So I need a piece of equipment that's gonna be very versatile, and basically what I'm looking for in that equipment today is that the basic framework of their philosophy, and it's like any grower, I'm gonna adapt it anyway to my particular situation.
For me personally, it first has to start with the economics. So does this make a cost-effective approach, or do you see the benefits of it being, if it is more costly, are there other benefits to it? And each one of them provided, I think, a small window into, yes, it might be a little bit more expensive, or no, it might be a little bit cheaper than using labor, but with it, do those other benefits outweigh those costs? I believe this actually is a great employment opportunity for bringing in a higher educated, trying to, instead of it just being a job, turning this more into a career opportunity. And I think that that's where, with robotics adoption, I think that that enables us to start bringing in a higher skilled working class that also would not be so temporary, but almost a year, not almost, but year-round type business.
There is not enough people looking for farm jobs as it is. I think these type of opportunities are going to keep, you know, farm kids on the farm because there's exciting technology there. So I think it's only going to be positive for agriculture jobs.
I just like that we in Colorado are on the cutting edge of this, or certainly trying to be on the cutting edge of this. We've had speakers say how diverse American agriculture is in the specialty crop market. I've worked in a lot of those markets and can attest to that. And so, yeah, I'm glad that we're a training ground, we're a proving ground that's on their radar. It legitimizes what we're doing here.
So mechanization and automation adoption for Colorado produce growers. I think it's first to make a distinguish between the two words. Mechanization replaces human muscle on farms, and automation replaces human decision making. Vegetable farms and fruit farms in Colorado have long employed mechanization solutions, so we'll continue to see that advance. We know from CSU research in 2021 that produce growers told us that if the conditions in Colorado around labor, recruitment, retention, and affordability didn't improve, they would look to mechanization and automation as their first choice to keep them in specialty crop production, fruits and vegetables. So I think this will phase in slowly. Growers have a lot of risk when they invest in this type of equipment in terms of knowing that it will function the way they want it to and that the return on investment makes sense. So we'll have some early adopters. We'll have people that are not so early, and they may observe their neighbors for a while and see how this works. But it does seem to be the future, knowing that workforce will continue to advance as a challenge around all of those issues of recruitment, retention, and affordability. So we'll look for it, and CSU will continue to walk with growers and help them explore and adopt this.
We need to understand this state that we've got this wonderful convergence of land, water, farmers, right here on our doorstep to provide us some wonderful resources to not only feed us, but provide us with healthy health compounds, and provides recreation, and provides so many things that improve our quality of life. And we need to find all the tools we can to be sustainable, and certainly mechanization and automation might be one step towards that direction.